Before vaccination came along, smallpox was one of the biggest killers and mutilators of mankind.
It's probably killed more people than all the wars in all of human history combined in the 20th century alone. 500 million people died of smallpox. That's an incredible number. That's a staggering number.
Following global eradication in 1980, the thought was that, well, we really don't need to vaccinate people anymore.
Most of the world has not been vaccinated against smallpox. So we are basically in a time when most people would be very susceptible to smallpox infections.
With a virus like smallpox, what you have is a ticking biological time bomb.
This is what a weapon of mass destruction in the 21st century looks like. And if this were dry-powdered variola virus, you'd carry half a pound in a briefcase and release it in the subway system. And it will change the course of history.
After this organism invades, you have up to 14 days, which the individual will feel perfectly well. And then the individual will begin to experience a fever.
And then eventually they get bumps, red bumps. These red bumps become blisters.
Blisters and then pustules.
For people who have a very mild disease, they may just have a dozen or so of these lesions. People that have really severe smallpox, it's confluent, it's all over their body. These people don't want to move, they don't want to even bend a joint because they'll start bleeding and they're hurting. And they're some of the most miserable people that you can imagine.
When smallpox invaded the body, you had the same rash that you had on the outside of your body going on in your throat, lungs, esophagus, stomach, intestines. It was terrible.
There was no treatment except to try to keep people comfortable.
It had a death rate between 20 and as high as 50%.
Doctors have never been able to identify exactly why a person dies of smallpox. It can simply overwhelm, devastate, and crash the human immune system. Smallpox is a true monster.